Howdy, welcome to my sound test of my new computer. I had to basically build a new computer practically, and it has a new motherboard, which has a new sound card. And I don't like it as much as the old motherboard sound card, but this is what I have, so I'm testing it out. I don't think this sound card is as loud as the old one, or it doesn't record as loud. Can turn up the boost, it'll pick up the background noise. But I'm playing this track right now. It's a P-51 versus V-1. That little plane looking thing listing right here is V-1. It's a German flying bomb. Looks like an airplane. It flies like an airplane. It has an autopilot inside. But it's a bomb. It's the biggest bomb. Fly at certain speed, at certain altitude, towards certain heading, for certain distance, and it'll cut off the engine, and the bomb will drop, and it'll explode upon its crash site. There it launches. And chasing it is the P-51 Mustang. The famous American fighter plane, right now being flown by the Royal Air Force of Great Britain. So one way to knock down that bomb, flying bomb, is to shoot it down. You want to ideally shoot off the engine or the wing. Ideally the wing, but you're very likely to hit the bomb itself. When that happens, it may detonate, and if you're close enough to shoot it, the bomb will kill you. The bomb's explosion is big enough to blow up your plane as well, so you don't really want to shoot it. So the next tactic is to topple it. You want to fly right next to it. I'm not kidding, you want to hit that thing with your wing. But you want to do it gently enough so your wing doesn't get damaged, because your wing is very fragile. So you want to fly wingtip to wingtip. You want to fly, you want to form up like you're forming up behind a wing leader. But you want to get closer. So you want to fly wingtip to wingtip. You want to very, very gently nudge it with your wing until it's toppled and beyond what the autopilot can recover, and then at which point the bomb will kind of fall into the ground, and you need to get the hell away from there, because that explosion can still hurt you. Oh, that was close. You don't want to fly into it. You don't want to fly into anything, period, but definitely don't want to fly into a big bomb like that. You wanna kinda get close, but not too close. Just right, and then kinda tip it over just like that. The bomb is on its way down. It tries to recover, but it's not gonna be able to. You will need to fly away from that, what would be the crash site. So that's what needs to be done, and that's something I really can't do, because I'm very horrible at getting information, and then I'm even worse at staying information. And this basically is the ultimate formation practice. So I'll try it. Royal Air Force P-51D. The bomb will fly off from waypoint 2 to waypoint 3 and beyond this island, and the engine will cut off. So I'll try to catch up to it before the engine cuts off. So I'm flying the P-51D. Down there is the simulated German V-1 launch site. There's two launch ramps set up with bombs. They will go off to my left. I'm gonna turn to my right 270 degrees, so I'll come up behind the bomb site and ultimately fly off to what is my currently left. So the Germans in real life would launch this thing from Belgium and France over the English Channel into England. So this would later be developed into what is now cruise missiles. Alright, so there goes one. I just saw the launch from the right ramp. Now that thing has a pulse jet engine. There's a jet trail behind it, jet steam trail behind it. Now I need it to get some altitude. I can't knock it down when it's too low, otherwise I won't have enough time to get away while it's falling. I'm gonna trim my plane down a bit because my plane tends to pull up. Now I want ultimately 100% propeller pitch and manual ready to control. There it is. Kinda hard to see. It's a camouflage painting. Now that thing will rise up to altitude 1200 meters and go up to speed of 350 kilometers per hour. I mean, it can go faster, but I think they set it. So it's like I'm flying up way too high right now. Try to get to it. I gotta go fast to catch up to it, but then I gotta slow down long before I get to it. There's no such thing as brakes in the airplanes. You hear air brakes and speed brakes and whatnot. They exist, but that's not the same kind of brakes you think of when you think of brakes from cars or bicycles. It's a very different concept. Used very differently for a different purpose. So to slow down, you just gotta adjust your throttle, use your drag, and use the gravity to slow down well in advance. So it's kind of very difficult, at least for me, to do it. Alright, I gotta get a little bit closer. Higher, maybe slower. Oh man, that thing exploded as soon as I touched it. So I couldn't touch the wingtip. I touched the bomb itself. I didn't know it would be that sensitive. But if you look carefully, here comes the second bomb. We are down there somewhere now. We are in pieces. But here comes the second bomb. Try to move the camera. I think it's kind of loud. You can hear it from about 9 to 10 miles away. Looks like an upside down Enterprise from this angle. But that thing will, the thing is right now set to go beyond that island and then just kind of die, or this island, and just kind of die. And then it'll fall into the ground or into the ocean and it'll explode. But yeah, so that's my sound test. I hope it's good enough so we can continue on with our regularly scheduled pilot careers.